वेलकम टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर क्लास माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11th. यू स्टार्ट लेक्चर नंबर 4 फ्रॉम लाइन नंबर 155. एक्ट 1 सीन 2. एक्ट 1 सीन 2 लाइन नंबर 155. द स्पीच ऑफ मिरांडा. मिरांडा सेज अलेक अलेक फॉर पिटी. I not remembering how I cried out then will cry it over again. It is a hint that rings mine eyes to it. Alas, how pitiful, as I do not remember how I cried then. I would cry in the way again. It is an event that forces me to shed tears. Prospero says here a little further. And then I will bring thee to the present business which now is upon us, without the which this story were most impertinent. Listen to a little more to what I tell you, and then I will come to the matter with which we have now to deal. Without that, my story would be irrelevant. Impertinent, irrelevant. Miranda says, wherefore did they not that hour destroy us? Why did they not kill us then? Prospero says, well demanded wench. Wench means girl. This is good question, my girl. This is good question. Well demanded wench. My tale provokes that question. This is good question. My story gives rise to that question. Dear, they durst not. So, dear, the love my people bore me, nor set a mark so bloody on the business. My dear, they dared not to kill us. Many my people loved me much. This was the reason. My people loved me very much. Besides, but with the colors fairer painted their foul ends. But they, beside it, first of all, my people loved me much. Besides, did they dare not make their plot look bloody? But he says, with colors fairer painted their foul ends, but they concealed their evil designs with an attractive appearance. In few, they hurried us aboard a bark, bore us some leagues to sea, where they prepared a rotten carcass of a butt, not rigged, nor tackle, sail, nor mast. The very rats instinctively have quit it. But they concealed their evil designs with an attractive appearance. To be brief, in short, I want to tell you, they speedily put us into a boat and took us several miles away over the sea. There, they prepared a rotten old boat without any equipment, ropes, sails, or mast. Even the rats would have instinctively means a natural or inherent impulse or behavior, innate behavior. Even the rats would have instinctively run away from the boat. That was in bad condition. There they hoist us to cry to the sea, the road to us to sigh, to the winds whose pity sighing back again did us but loving wrong. We could only cry, out to the ocean which roared back at us, and we could only sigh to the winds which sighed back in sympathy. Thus, whatever harm the ocean did to us was done out of love for us. Miranda says, alack, what trouble was I then to you? Alas, what a trouble I must have been to you at that time, when I was accompanying you. Prospero says, oh, a cherubim, thou wast that did preserve me, thou didst smile, infused me a fortitude from heaven, when I have decked the sea with drops full salt, under my burden groaned, which raised in me an undergoing stomach to bear up against what should ensure. Rather, you were an angel. You have not disturbed me. You have not given me any trouble. Rather, you were an angel that saved me from despair, from hopelessness. You kept smiling as if inspired with great courage by heaven, when I was sprinkling the ocean with saltish tears, and when I was groaning under my grief. Your smiles raised my spirits and enabled me to stand up against such misfortunes. Miranda says, how came we ashore? How did we manage to reach the shore? Prospero says, by providence divine, by God's grace. Some food we had and some fresh water that a noble Neapolitan Gonzalo, out of his charity, who being then appointed master of the design, did give us, with rich garments, linens, stuffs, and necessaries, which since have stayed much. So of his gentleness, knowing I loved my books, he furnished me from mine own library with volumes that I prize above my dukedom. Prospero says, we had some food and some fresh water, which a noble Neapolitan Gonzalo gave us out of pity. Gonzalo had been appointed to execute the whole plan. He gave us costly cloths, linens, goods, and essential commodities which have been of use to us since then. And in the same way, out of his kindness, knowing that I loved my books, he supplied me from my library with books that I value more than my dukedom. Miranda says, would I might but ever see that man. I wish I could see that man whenever possible. Prospero says, now I arise, resumes his mantle, again he wears his robe. Sit still and hear the last of our sea sorrow. Here in this island we arrived, and here have I, thy schoolmaster, made thee more profit than other princes can, that have more time for vainer arts and tutors not so careful. Sit still, Miranda, and hear the end of our suffering. We landed on this island, and here I have acted as your teacher. I have taught you more than what is taught to other princesses, who waste their time in useless occupations as well as in tutors who are not competent. Miranda says, heavens thank you for it. And now I pray you, sir, for still it's beating in my mind your reason for raising this sea storm. May God reward you for it. And now I request you, sir, for this question is still troubling me. Tell me why you caused this storm. What answer Prospero gives, you will study in my next lecture, and that would be lecture number 5. It will be taught lecture number 5 on 5th July 21. Thank you so much, students.